Hello, church family. My name is Anthony Edwards, and I'd like to share a word of encouragement with you. I was looking at some, I was on social media, and I saw a tweet by Tony Dungy. I don't know if you know who Tony Dungy is. He's a football coach. He played in the NFL. He coached the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, got them pretty far. Then he left there, and he went to Indianapolis and coached Peyton Manning, and they won a Super Bowl. And then he retired. Now I think he's an announcer on CBS or some one of those NFL talk shows. One of his kids did commit suicide, but he's a godly man, and he happens to be African American. Well, anyway, he sent out a tweet on the 4th of July, and I'm gonna read it to you. It said, "Over the last few weeks, we have focused on America's faults. We must work to improve those things, but today we should celebrate our country's birthday. We enjoy a lot of blessings, and I'm thankful to live in America. I pray that God will show us how to help our country grow." And I thought that was pretty interesting, and I looked at some of the comments that followed afterwards, and some people were ripping them, and some people were saying, good job. And then some of the things Tony responded to, and I thought that was pretty interesting. So, but that's what we're here to talk about today, and hopefully I can encourage you in that. Colossians 3:13 says, "Make allowances for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others." And I thought that scripture, I'm like loving right now Colossians 3. Colossians 3 is just unbelievable. It talks about setting our affections on things above. It talks about putting off some things that are lurking inside you and putting on some things. And it's a beautiful chapter. I mean, it's a beautiful chapter. But Christ, if we want to be his disciples, you know, Christ said we must deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow him. Part of denying yourself is letting God be God. God is God, and we're not. God is the final judge. He'll have the final say in everything. So we just have to trust in him. As like in there's a scripture in Psalms 119 that says, "Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." God is good. He'll show us the way to go. And his way is perfect because God is good and he's merciful. And God is not like a man where he can lie. But he won't change. He'll do what he says, and he'll fulfill all his promises. So brothers and sisters, be encouraged. And let's remember to make allowances for each other's faults, especially in our small groups and other church family members. Let's make allowance for each other's faults, and if someone offends us, let's try to forgive them and move forward. It's tough. I'm not perfect on that. I'm not perfect, but I'm striving to be that. And with the God's help and the Holy Spirit, I will be where I need to be. I hope you're encouraged, brothers and sisters. God bless.